7 years on from one of the deadliest tower block fires in history, finally some answers. In June 2017, in the wealthiest part of the UK, an electrical fault on the fourth floor of a public housing tower quickly turned to tragedy. The fire rapidly spread up the Grenfell Tower, fuelled by combustible cladding that lined the 24-storey building. As the inferno raged, many residents could not escape and could not be rescued. 72 people, mostly poor and non-English speaking, died. The tragedy sparked deep introspection in Britain about how the country was and still is divided by race and class. And tonight, the UK government has handed down the final report into that dark day. Our Europe correspondent Johnpaul Gonzo is at the Grenfell Memorial and has been following this story. Johnpaul, what does the report say?
Ursula, it is scathing. It says decades of failures by governments, regulators and companies turned the building into a death trap. The report didn't identify a single cause of the tragedy, but it did take aim at those involved in the 2016 refurbishment of the tower, which was when that cladding was added. The manufacturers of that building material deliberately concealed the fire risk it posed. What this public inquiry has also found is that there was a persistent indifference to fire safety from the local council, particularly the safety of vulnerable people.
The simple truth is that the deaths that occurred were all avoidable, and those who lived in the tower were badly failed over a number of years and in a number of different ways by those who were responsible for ensuring the safety of the building and its occupants. Not all of them bear the same degree of responsibility for the eventual disaster, but as our reports show, all contributed to it in one way or another, in most cases through incompetence, but in some cases through dishonesty and greed.
The whole point of this public inquiry is to ensure that a tragedy like this never happens again. Many recommendations have been made, including better training for firefighters who were woefully unprepared for what they faced on that day. Many people have been coming down to the memorial here to reflect and pay their respects. It is a solemn day. Grenfell United, a group made up of victims, relatives and also survivors, well, they are taking the time to process this report. But so far, they say that justice has not been served. Ursula.
Thank you, Johnpaul.